Hello, hello, Jeff Helvin here with Ballen Brands, and today I want to show you how to import contacts into Infusionsoft. Now, one of the first things that we need to do when we're importing contacts into Infusionsoft is we need to get the data that we actually want to import. So, of course, that's going to be an export. So, if we look at different systems that you might be using, they should provide some sort of an export. I'm going to actually show you an export here in Infusionsoft just to give you an idea of what we might look for somewhere else. And then I'm going to use that export to help me configure my fields. So in Infusionsoft, one of the best ways to do this is if I locate any number of contacts in the system, whether it's a single contact or multiple contacts, it's going to provide me a result. And in this result, when I select these different contacts, under Actions, I can actually do an export. So when I click on export, it's going to give me options. I can actually save different types of exports in Infusionsoft. This may not be options in other systems, but I'm able to save different kinds of exports if I want to consistently maybe export a list of people, but I only care about certain information, or if I want to export everything. In this case, I'm going to actually export all fields. So you'll see that I can actually choose, it's already pre-selected, every different field that Infusionsoft has and what we have set up in this system. So again, you might have something similar. You may not be able to choose which fields that you're exporting. It may export all fields in another system, but regardless, this is what we're going to work with here. So next, you choose the format. Do you want it in a CSV, an Excel, or a zip file? CSV is what's most commonly accepted. If you download a CSV file, you can open it in Excel and then you can save it back as a CSV. But traditionally, I like to use CSV files in order to be most compatible from one system to the next. You can also choose a delivery method here in this case, which basically it'll let you download it in the browser, or it can send me an email with a link to it in case it's a large file. We have that option as well. And then again, in Infusionsoft, I'm able to actually save the settings in case I want to do the same export next time for a different set of information. But in this case, I'm just going to go ahead and click Process. So, after I've downloaded a record, I open it, I double click on it, and in my program here, it opens in numbers. I'm on a Mac. If I had Excel, it can open in Excel. But basically, it opens up a spreadsheet program. And from here, I actually have all of the different field names. So, we have phone 2 and extensions and emails. And then, if I keep scrolling over, we've got all the different address fields that we have. If I continue to go here, then I'm going to have my different phone fields. I have tags, so if I use tags in another system, then we can create tags in here, no problem. I have person types, we have job title, I mean, really just anything that we collect. I've also set up a lot of custom fields in our app for, original source, where they came from, what address fields, like what properties that they're interested in. In this case, of course, for real estate, their IDX interaction, if I have that information, the contract information, like open escrow date and the price and so forth. So this just continues to go on, and I have basically all that I need access to, every field that I can import. Now, on your import from another system, you're going to have different things. Like instead of phone 1, it might be like home phone or main phone or something like that. And so sometimes we have to make some decisions here on what information we're going to put in what columns. So here what I'm showing you is basically I want to work backwards. I'm trying to get information from another system into Infusionsoft. So I want to ideally use Infusionsoft information, or I'm sorry, the field names. I want to use those in order to preserve the correct data. So what I can do also is it's a lot easier to make updates in a spreadsheet on like a larger scale than it is to once you've already imported the data into Infusionsoft. So I recommend when you export your data to really take a look and decide what fields you care about. Now, if I have fields that have nothing in them, like spouse name in this case, I'm just gonna delete the column. I don't need to import that. There's nothing in there that matters. Maybe I don't use the company fields. So I'm just gonna go ahead and delete that as well. I don't use the company ID, so I can delete it. And you can really whittle this down just to the information that matters to you. If you're not doing addresses, if you're not doing additional phone fields, things like that, you can literally just delete them so that you're left with only the things that you care about. And this really just helps keep a better pulse on your data so that you can more easily go through it and actually import what's relevant, what matters. So if we're importing, for instance, a list of leads that have never done a contract with us, well, then I don't need any of the contract fields. So I can just delete all of those and leave myself only with the things that I do have, the information that I do have. So as you see, I've kind of whittled this down, at least just to the ones that I don't have data for, so that I can more easily see what information I care to import. Okay. Now, if I was importing from another system, let's say these names were different, you'll see there's name fields, and then there's a first and a last name field that are separate. There's birthday and there's phone ones, and then there's actually like the phone one record with the extension. So there's lots of different ways to kind of work through this, and we can help with this, by the way, if you're having some struggles or if you do work with us on getting you set up. I'm just trying to show a little bit of how we kind of prepare that information. So really what I want to leave you with here in this part of it is let's just get rid of anything that doesn't matter in the new system. Delete out any columns that we're not going to import, any additional fields that we're not, just so that we can get back down to only the things that matter. In some cases, it's literally just first name, last name, email, and a phone number. If you had them tagged in another system, well then, you know, maybe your certain tags might be something that you care about. So you can keep those. So we'll keep that in here. And then also whether it was a buyer or a seller, or whether they were a hot or cold lead, things like that. You know, we might want to preserve all of that information. So, all right. So here is data. Now, if I had, say, 15 more fields that I wanted to add, I can literally at this point just do that if they're all in the same column format. So I could, again, it's much easier in some cases just to do it in a spreadsheet if you know you have maybe 10 business cards sitting over here on the on the desk here. If we just want to go ahead and import that information, we might just do it here on a spreadsheet and do an import. Okay. All right. So now that I have my data, like I said, to do an import, we want to make sure it's a CSV file. So I'm going to go ahead and save this as a CSV file, and we're going to do Infusionsoft import sample. Okay. So it's a CSV file. So now in Infusionsoft, it's very easy to kind of work through this. So under the Infusionsoft logo icon in the top left, I'm going to hover over that, and under admin, I'm going to go to import data. Now, Infusionsoft also gives us a little, like some little helpers. So if you're importing it from Outlook or Constant Contact or one of these, you can choose those tools. But in this case, I'm just going to go ahead and import contacts. So I'm going to click go. Now, there's also a little video. You can download a sample CSV file, which is kind of what I showed you, what I did here at Infusionsoft. We did it that way. Or you could watch a little video about importing contacts as well if this one isn't helpful enough. So now I'm going to choose my CSV file. So I'm going to click Browse. I'm going to choose my IS import sample and hit Open. And what this is doing now is importing. Looks like there's a delay there. Hold on. Browse. IS import sample. Perfect. So now what it's doing is it just uploaded it here. And I'm going to click Next. So what happens is it's now taking my field, this is my fields for my CSV, and trying to match them to Infusionsoft fields, okay? So if you left in fields you don't care about, you can simply just no match. You could just not match them up at all and just leave them empty, and that's fine. But the ones you do care about, let's say first name and last name, we have that here. Now the name field, I can actually choose. In Infusionsoft, there's a couple of rules here where I can actually choose split full name to first and last. Now, because I import or exported this from Infusionsoft, I already have the first and last name separate, so I don't need this field at all. So I'm still just going to click no match on that. But if you were importing from a list from somewhere else that didn't give you the broken down first name and last name, that's how Infusionsoft collects their data, is in separate fields. So what you'd want to do is just use this name field. These two wouldn't exist in your record, but you'd use this name field and you'd choose that option to split full name to first and last. Okay, now then I'm just going down the list. So maybe this said birth date and I have to match it to birthday, for example. That might be something that happens. Or yours might say primary phone and you want to make sure that goes to the phone one number. for example. So these are different ways that you might, like different things that you look at. This might say email address, and so we need to match it to email. In this case, the system already picked up the appropriate one, but you just want to double check that each one equals the correct record. So I'm not going to choose the rest of these just for the sake of time here. So now I'm going to go ahead and click Next. Now what this does is this tells you, okay, you had values in your CSV file that don't match the values to the actual name. So maybe instead of hot lead, we have warm or we have urgent or something like that. We can actually say that if it says this over here, make it say this instead over there. All right, so then when I click Next, the last thing it does is it's going to ask me, do you plan on sending email marketing to these contacts? Well, in most cases, yes, we do. Any campaigns, we do. We definitely want to have communication with them, right? So any of the campaigns are considered this email marketing. So we definitely want to have people in campaigns. That's how we nurture them. That's how we can keep them up. So in this case, I'm in a what they call a sandbox app, so I don't actually have the ability to send email marketing, but it will ask you a series of questions on what kind of communication you plan to have with them, where did the data come from, and all of this is in an effort to keep you from, you know, getting picked up by spam bots and search engines. I'm sorry, not search engines, but blacklists and things like that for email communication, because we want to respect the email service, basically, and Infusionsoft wants to keep a good reputation. They want you to keep a good reputation. So it's going to ask you some questions on that. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and click Next. And then it gives us me a preview. It'll actually give me a preview of every contact if you really wanted to go through them all. But it shows you what's going to match up. So first name is going to say Tom, last name is going to say Smith, lead source is empty, owner ID is Jeff, the tags are these, email, phone, number, and so forth. So from here, it's a pretty, you know, again, there's not a lot that you can mess up if you look and pay attention to where these things are coming from. Once you've done that, you click Done, and then the list is imported. So it's pretty easy, pretty straightforward. Now, what's cool is once that list is imported, you'll get a link that says view all of the contacts from this import. So you can actually click that link, and essentially it goes back to a list like this. Once the page loads here, it goes back to a list like this that shows you all of the contacts that were from that particular import. What it's also done is, and you don't see it in here because I didn't do the import, but it actually automatically creates a tag that says import, and it'll have today's date and time of when that was imported. So if you ever need to go back to any contacts that were imported on this date, you can actually look them up by the tag that was applied. Okay? So a couple other, before I finish this up here, a couple other things that I'd like to just kind of touch base on just as a way to help. When I go back to my spreadsheet, some of the things are, for instance, you might have multiple users in the system. And so we want to have, with those users, we want to assign owners. So maybe you run a team of five different people, so you have five different imports that you're going to get. Well, on that actual import sheet, or on the spreadsheet, I should say, we want to make sure we specify who the owner is. Now, Infusionsoft works in owner IDs. So in this case, this owner field wouldn't actually be what we use. It's actually going to use this owner ID. So yours might say, you know, contacts or agent or something like that. And then we're going to look up that owner ID. So back in Infusionsoft, if I go under the users tab, I can see in here which owner I have, what their ID is. So in my case, owner ID is one. So this gives me an option now to just pre-fill all of these. So if I owned all of these, well, again, it's just quicker and easier to just go ahead and pre-fill and pre-populate all those if these are all ones that I own in particular. The other thing that might come up is you may not actually have, maybe you have a field in your old database that you don't have yet in Infusionsoft and you want to preserve that information. For example, some clients have lender names. Well, that's not a field that we have pre-installed in Infusionsoft. So if you want to keep track of the lenders that you have, what I do is I actually go into Infusionsoft and I go ahead and create that field first. So under the tab, I go under Admin and Settings. And I'm going to set up custom fields for contacts and I hit Go. So these are the additional fields that we've already set up in most cases for our clients. And then, again, we might decide that there are some other fields that we want to import. So if that's the case, I'm going to go ahead and just add a field. We'll call this one lender name. And it's just going to be a text area. And then I'm going to choose to put it under, let's say, the contract terms and transaction details. Maybe that's where I want it. So I'm going to save that field. Well, now when I go to my field here, I can simply just add it, lender name. Or again, if you already had it on your other export that you're using, then you know that lender name, it's just a text field. So we don't need to use IDs or any of that kind of stuff. It's not a user, but it's just a text field. So now that lender name will be one of my field options when I do the import. So that's a quick rundown. Well, not so quick, I guess, but that's a rundown of how to get data from one system into another. This is something that we help our clients with. If you have any troubles there, feel free to reach out to team@ballenbrands.com, and we'd love to help you. Any other questions? We look forward to hearing from you.